why is knowing your free light chain ratio important?
So light chains tend to go up in a person who has inflammation. So that could be from any number of things, like an infection even. And what the ratio helps to do is just normalize those values. So as I mentioned, you know, people will have higher light chains when they have kidney problems. But typically you have an elevation of both kappa and lambda. And when you create that ratio, it might be off a little bit, but usually it's not above that cutoff of, say, you know, certainly of 100, for example. So you can use that ratio to say, you know, do you think this is a non-specific elevation of light chains rather than something that is really important to look at.
When we do blood tests to look for the light chains in the blood or serum-free light chains, we get three results from the lab. We get what's called a kappa light chain, a free lambda light chain, and a light chain ratio, a kappa to lambda ratio. And these three values are very important for several reasons. The fact that the kappa and the lambda light chains are two light chains that our body normally makes, whether we are healthy or we are sick or we have multiple myeloma. And an elevated light chain can be caused by several things. It could be caused by inflammation, by an infection, by stress, or cancer, or some therapy related to it. So if we see the kappa light chain, for example, go up, but the lambda light chain stays the same and it's not going up, they're not going up together, then that can be a sign that there is abnormal cells there that are making more of one type of light chain than the other. If we see that both light chains are going up, then that can tell us that that's more of a reactive process. And that's normal to see in any patient. Remember, myeloma cell comes from an abnormal plasma cell, and a plasma cell is very important for our immune system. And it's going to react whenever we have an infection or we're exposed to an agent like an allergen or inflammation. Its behavior is going to be to increase the amount of antibodies that it produces so it can try to identify bacteria or pathogens that could be attacking the body. And just like it produces whole antibodies, it's going to be producing fragments of those antibodies, which are the free light chains. So if we see that both light chains go up together, then that tells us that this is more of a reactive process or an infectious process and not necessarily a cancer. If we see that one of them is the one that's being going up while the other's staying stable or going down, then that tells us that there's something wrong and there's a group of cells that are making more of one element than the other. And that's where we need to focus on. And in myeloma, that's what we see. We see an abnormal, a disproportionate increase of one of those free light chains compared to the other. And the ratio is the one that helps us determine how much of a difference there is between one and the other. The normal ratio of a light chain can go between 0.26 to 1.65. And that is something that everybody has. And if we have both light chains go up at the same time, the ratio should stay the same. If we have somebody, like in the case of myeloma, that has a kappa light chain go up, we should see that ratio go up, and that should signal us that there is a higher amount of cancer cells producing that abnormal type of light chain. There are some scenarios where we can see a false elevation of one of those light chains, specifically people who have end-stage renal disease or very bad kidney function. In those cases, we can see a false elevation of the kappa light chains that make that range of 0.26 to 1.65 be extended up to 3. And in those cases, having that abnormal ratio doesn't necessarily mean that there's a possible cancer or MGUS or an abnormal clone. It just means that the kidneys are not processing the light chains at the same rate because we tend to accumulate more kappa than lambda. And that's what throws the ratio slightly off.